vehicle that we have here is the Standard B Liberty truck. The United States Marine Corps had no vehicles of their own when they served in France. The Marine Brigade came over to France armed with their rifles, bayonets, and pistols. Everything else that they used in combat, their grenades, their machine guns, their light machine guns, are all going to be supplied by either England or France. The trucks are going to be supplied by the United States Army or the French government. This truck, representative of the Liberty trucks, manufactured and sent over to France in large numbers in 1918, represents a landmark in military transportation. This vehicle is able to take a squad of Marines and all their equipment and transport them over long distances. It could also be used to transport supplies, to take wounded Marines and soldiers off of the battlefield. This is going to be the first time that the United States military is going to have a purpose-built motorized truck that it's going to use in large quantities. The Standard B here is particularly of importance to us because it was a ground-up restoration, a team effort by both our restoration team and our volunteers here at the museum. The vehicle has a canvas cover, and on the canvas cover it says USQMC. It does not reflect on the United States Marine Corps in any way, shape, or form. The USQMC corresponds to the United States Quartermaster Corps. People that are going to supply and control these vehicles and allocate them out to the Army divisions that are going to use them in the field. The vehicle is going to have hard rubber tires. These are not inflatable tires. And in fact, there was no source for both the hard rubber tires on this vehicle or to make the replacement steel wheels that were needed. The Strasburg Railroad is going to cast these for our museum, making this the totally authentic vehicle that it is before you. Each one of these, along with the hard rubber tire, represents a step back in engineering in order to accomplish the restoration of the vehicle. The open cab, subject to the wind, the driver with a horn and one headlight, is going to make his way across the roads of France, ferrying Marines to and from the battle, bringing in supplies, and taking out the wounded after the battle is done.